We are going to check in with, excuse me.
Checking in with Kelly Hesedahl. Yeah, you might be out looking at the waters and wondering, what is that red hue out there? Well, it's all for a good reason. We're going to have Kelly explain it all now.
Scientists have a good reason for it.
That's right. You know, we are on Fiesta Island. We were hoping to get a better shot of that red dye, but it was released across the bay from where I'm standing right now, kind of where you see those mobile homes over there. It was released this morning, and it's a way for biologists to study the way water flows into and out of the bay.
Along with that water comes nutrients, it comes sediments, it comes with potential pollutants, and so we want to see how the water is flowing in all the different sections of the bay and then eventually out into the ocean.
And that was Cheryl Jenkins, an environmental biologist for the city. She says understanding how the water moves will help them plan for future projects, including habitat restoration projects. So we do have a better vantage point from a drone that took some video. The dye is called rhodamine. It is a safe, non-toxic chemical. It's safe in drinking water, natural water, and salt water. The city released 8 pounds of the powder substance into the bay around 7:30 this morning near the Rose Creek Inlet to the bay from the Mike Gotch Memorial Pedestrian Bridge between Campland on the bay and De Anza Cove. Now, the reason this is happening now is because the king tides have returned to our beaches, and Jenkins says they give a big picture of how everything is moving. So right now, researchers are in boats. They're collecting data. They will be analyzing it. Back out here live again, that dye is safe. This project had to be approved by the EPA. It is okay for you to get into the water this weekend. The water just might look a little bit different.